This morning when I woke up, I had no clue. No clue what I was going to film. It was dull. I was a bit miserable. And I thought, well, what do I do? Do I just sit at home and think of something else to film indoors, or should I do something? So I thought, well, I've got an opportunity, right? If it's reasonable, I can go out, maybe just make a vlog or a video out of something. So this is what I'm doing. I'm just gonna take the camera, go near the water, see what I can see. Wonderful. One of the things that's great about being in the UK is that within a few minutes you can walk from your house, which could be in the centre of town, and then you could be here in a beautiful idyllic place next to the water. This is actually the River Thames, which is runs through London and various other parts of the UK. And actually I'm just on the outskirts of Eton, famous for Eton College and stuff like that. I've done a video about being here before. There's still planes going over, of course, because not too far away from Heathrow and one of the main airports. But look at this, it's beautiful here. The sun has actually started to shine, which is totally unexpected, considering when I left this morning it was raining, and now it's nice. This is one of the unpredictable things that you get being in the UK, is the weather. I know we talk about it a lot, but that's what it's like living here. Anyway, let's shoot some stuff. It's pretty. I don't know how much sunlight I've got, so let's just do some things and see what it turns out like. Wondering what lenses I have with me today. I have two. I have the Sigma 16mm Micro Four Thirds lens, and I also have the Sigma 18-35 on the speed booster. And these are the two lenses I use the most. They're super sharp, great quality, and then a couple of ND filters, of course, because it's bright and it's dark and it's bright and it's dark. I have a variable ND filter on the front of this, which I'm just trying to adjust now to get some reasonable exposure. I know the highlights are pretty blown, but hey, that's all right. So I'm going to investigate and have a mess around here, just see what else I can find. I haven't been down this route before in Eton near the canal, so let's just have a look. So another bit of kit that I take with me when I'm just out and about, as I am today, is the Joby GorillaPod, because it's just so versatile, lightweight. You can basically mount your camera on anything, from a tree to an iron fence, railings, anything you like. Really just easy to take out and about with you. One thing I've learned since doing these videos and things is that I tend to not take as much footage as I should. And people are saying, well, you know, always take more than you think. I have a tendency to take a little bit of video and then just stop, thinking that's enough. But it's always better to have too much than not enough, because you can always cut stuff out, you can do editing, that's what it's all about, right? But if you don't have a lot of video to make your vlog or your film or your wedding or whatever you're doing, then you're stuffed. You can't make this stuff up afterwards. So my advice to any filmmaker out there, or anybody who wants to just create these So my advice to any filmmaker or anybody who wants to just create content is to just take as much video as your SD card allows. In fact, just buy more SD cards, more batteries. Then you can just film as much rubbish content that you want, and then you can just find the best bits and make a nice video. Because if you don't, you'll end up with nothing. So that's what I'm doing today, just taking, you know, random bits of video that I may never use, getting close to the water, and yeah, I might never use it, but you don't know, right? So let's just see.